Hi everyone, this is Miranda from Miranda's Ornaments, and today I am going to show you how to make these cute little balls, Christmas balls, and these are a part of a large starfish kit which contains 7 of these starfish design balls which have a measurement of 6 centimeters in diameter. The little ones have a diameter of 4 centimeters, and there are 7 starfish balls and 7 little balls of these. And well, I am Dutch. My English is not that good, so I hope you can all understand me. And this is also my first video, so I'm kind of nervous, but I'm going to try to be as clear as I can possibly be. This kit will be for sale on my Etsy site, just so you know. And these little balls have markings already, and these markings already fit, and you can very easily divide it into 6 parts, which I'm going to mark now. I think it's not going to show on the video very well, but these little ones I'm going to zoom in. Okay. So these balls already have these markings. I doubt if you can see them, but going to mark them, and these balls are in the kit, of course, so you won't have any trouble finding those marks. Now you need a centimeter. I forgot to tell you what you need. You need a fine liner or a trick marker. You need a centimeter. You need a tucking tool. You can also use a metal nail file. I use this one, Japanese tucking tool. I love this one. Scissors. You're going to need a sharp knife. This one is from Fiskars, but of course I don't know what brands are all available in the United States or elsewhere. You need a glue gun, or you can use an embroidery needle or something to put a glue stick in the seams later on, but I'm going to show that later. So you're going to mark those parts. And I will try to stay on camera. Well, this isn't very nice, but we can fix that. Whoops. Now I'm being clumsy. Yay! You won't be able to find anything once the fabric is on, so now we mark the ball. Ouch, that was my glue gun, that's hot already. You mark the entire ball. Now you will be needing your sharp knife. And you will be, let me get this out of the way. And you will cut. But let me, the right word, shallow. Don't cut too deep. Maybe that's a better description. Typing English is in most cases much more easy because you get to look up the words if you don't know them, and you can think about what you're going to type first. So don't cut too deep because you will have your little ball. It's only 4 centimeters in diameter. You're going to have your little ball in two. And I'm speaking from experience, so please be warned and don't let it happen to you. Now, I also made a Dutch version of this video, and ouch, I'm going to put my glue gun away. Stupid me. Did I go around entirely? Yes, I think so. So now for the next. I edited videos in the past, just family videos, and just putting some lines underneath, but not editing like rotating because my camera is upside down, and also not knowing how to attach little pieces of movie together. So I am not going to edit much, so all the bloopers will remain. New in this field, the starfish tutorial is a PDF with lots of pictures and explanation, very detailed. It also comes with the kit. If you have already purchased the Starfish tutorial, you can of course only buy the kit. Now let me see if I had them. No, I need another one. And when you have a larger ball, you can just make deeper cuts, but I'm being really careful with this one. Well, I guess I went through them all. Yes. Now, I have 3 pieces left for the last one. And what I like to do is I like to cut them up front like this. But if you're not trusting yourself with doing this, please don't. I will show you how to do it otherwise. Now you need your glue stick. And now you're going just to put a thin layer on one part of the ball. These little patches just match exactly, so you can just put them on the line hold it and just equally divide the fabric according to the lines. Where's my tucking? Here's my tucking tool. And you're going to look where the grooves are, seams, whatever. And you're going to tuck it in. Now, did I forget? No, I missed it. And just tuck it in. Really carefully. You don't want your ball to be in half. So, this is your first part. And now you're going to do the opposite part. Put the glue stick on. And put the same red patch over here. And then I'll be back. Now you have both of those patches tucked in. And now I'm going to show you, if you're not comfortable with cutting the fabric up front, you can also do this. You just take the patch, put it on here. Like that, and divide it. And hold it between thumb and index finger. And what you're going to do next is, let's see, where's that line? You're going to tuck it in just a little. Like that, and the other side. It's much easier because the red patch is already there. Let's see if we can adjust this a little bit. Now you tucked it in on both sides. Now you're going to use your scissors to cut away the excess fabric. Like so. And now you're going to tuck in what's left of the fabric that's peeking out. Nasty little piece over there. And there we have it. Now you're going to do the opposite side with the same cream colored fabric. Don't like the lighting. I hope it shows better on camera later. And then I have two green patches left. You're going to do them over here and over there. And I'll see you in a bit. So now that you're done, you're going to take a little pin. It's an 18 18 millimeter pin. You're going to put it through the end of this cord, like that, and you're going to put it on top, in top of this ball, and just get away in the seam a bit, like that. Now, there are numerous ways which you can use to put glue in here. I prefer to use a glue gun with a fine tip. I know in the US they sell the Shearbonder. It isn't for sale in the Netherlands, so I'm using a rapid egg point. I'm not very fond of this one because this mechanism doesn't work properly. But for now, I'm lucky because it's working. And you just use a thin layer of glue. And you wrap the cord, you just lay the cord in the seams, and there it goes snagging again. So I'm going to push it a little, and hopefully I will be able to finish. You can just easily get rid of those little glue gun dried pieces. Glue stick, dried pieces, hot glue gun stick. Now we're going around the corner here. Like so. I have to move my arm around the long piece that's sticking out of my glue gun right now. Maybe I can do it like this. Okay. So that's better. And we're going around a little corner again. Of course, if you're all familiar with this, you can fast forward. Because I can understand this piece is pretty boring. right, almost there. Well, this dried a little, so just put the tip on it and it will melt again. Alright, now we're going to measure about 10 centimeters for the hanger, like so. Cut it off and I have a green pin. And we're going to put it in the cord, through the cord, and we're going to take a bit of hobby glue. Any hobby glue will do fine, and just make sure there's a thin layer on your decoration pin. Now you're going to make a loop and put it right through the cord in the middle of your bauble, like this. And just press it firmly. And you can easily get all the little glue gun wires out of there. So this is it. Little ball is done, and I'm going to wish you all up front a Merry Christmas, and hope you enjoyed the video, and see you next time.